Good day, fellas. I hope you're ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we have something very, very, very unusual for you. Today Wargaming published information about the clash, team clash, clash of commanders, however you are calling this event. So what is going to happen right there? There is going to be four teams, four very, very famous for content creators. Death Games, which every single of us know and we love him with all our heart. There is going to be a Myland, most popular, if I'm not mistaken, the German content creator, right? We play together and he's a very, very good guy. I met him, I tried to hug him, but he said, "Wee!" There is awesome epic guys which have a cucumber in their hands and you need to be afraid of them. Obviously, I'm joking, and they're very, very good guys. I have met them in certain events, and there is me, Skill for L2, right? And what is going to happen as this event, because probably not everyone is going into Wargaming page to check the things out and so on, so on. Pretty much this event will start very, very soon, in couple of days, and all information is going to be obviously under the video, so feel free to click that link and to check it out. You can win all sorts of stuff. And what we are going to do today, my lovely friends, we are going to watch the video, what Wargaming have done. I seen it already. I needed to prepare for this video for obvious reasons. This is, by the way, this is very, very important moment. We are doing this for a very first time. We are doing something else, not playing the game, not commenting on the gameplay or something. So, fellas, this is very, very important part. Soon we are going to watch Titanic together. Prepare this thing for your tears, and we are going to watch that all together. Obviously, now jokes aside, let's go and watch this stuff.
From January 30th to February 10th, a large-scale and dynamic event is making its European debut in World of Tanks, Team Clash. Join a team captained by one of these famous content creators, right in the game client. Mailland, Skill for LTU, Des Games, or Awesome Epic Guys. You won't be able to switch sides after making your decision, so pick your favorite wisely. In Team Clash, you...
My lovely friends, before picking the team, if you don't know what those other guys are, you are watching only my content, feel free to go and check them out. All of them are streaming on Twitch, pretty much on a very, very daily basis, right? All of them have their YouTube channels. Go check them out. Maybe you are going to find your favorite one, and you will join his team. You will get him as a commander. So check it out, fellas. Everyone should have an equal chance, and if you do not know someone, you should check it out. It will take 3 seconds, and either you are going to fall in love with a person, either not.
Earn points that are simultaneously credited to both your personal and team progression. The team with most points wins in the final. By contributing significantly to your team's victory alongside your teammates, you'll get closer to valuable rewards, unique customization, a style, and other elements. The cherry on top, you'll also receive a commander that looks and sounds just like your favorite content creator. To earn points, you'll need to fight in the new mode. It's a simple format, 7v7, tier 10 vehicles only, and counter battles on a select set of maps. Each team will have just one platoon and a maximum of one SPG. Oh, and the main condition, be ready to win no matter what. If you don't have a tier 10 vehicle in your garage, that's fine.
So what is all happening right there, fellas? There is going to be, remember, 7 versus 7 battles. I'm speaking with old school players right there. Pretty much what we are going to have. We are going to have 7 versus 7 battles. And whenever you are going to pick a team, how everything is going to go for, you are going to go either to play with your platoon in 7 versus 7, so 3 guys including you, or you can play solo and you can meet random people, same like random battles, and you are doing your tactical decisions during in the battle. It's pretty much like randoms, but 7 versus 7. If you don't have a tier 10s, they are saying you can pretty much get one for free.
We've joined a team for the event will be given a rental tank. You will be able to get a few more rental vehicles by earning points. All this means anyone can take part in the new mode. An additional way of accumulating points is to complete special missions in random battles.
Okay, so there is going to be daily missions in the random. So not even you need to play, or if you want to play, you want to fight for your favorite content creator and everything. Not even you can do that in the special 7v7 mode, because it's definitely not for everyone. So you can play randoms and you can play and get some points and so on, so on. So keep this in mind, couple of battles in randoms, couple of battles in 7v7 if you want to help your content creator out and fight for his team.
They're updated every day, and these are missions for causing damage, earning experience, and placing in the top 5 on your team by XP in a winning battle. The content creators themselves won't be just standing on the sideline. They'll have access to special perks that only they can activate. There are 6 perks, and each of them will help every member of the team earn more points in the 7v7 battles. Morale Boost allows players to earn twice as many personal points for the next 2 hours. It also gives a multiple bonus to team points earned depending on the content creator's position in the leaderboard. The Tactical Ploys perk allows for earning a certain number of points regardless of the battle outcome. Intense Battle offers up twice as many points for a victory if it's achieved within 5 minutes. Prudent Approach doubles the points if the team is victorious and loses no more than 2 vehicles. Territorial Control gives double the points if the team wins by base capture. Finally, Frontal Assault activates a team challenge. A combined effort, you'll need to earn a certain number of team points. If you succeed, you'll get significantly more. This is the only perk that doesn't affect personal points. Content creators can use each of these perks once every 24 hours. They can't use other perks while another is active. The perk effect doesn't apply to the battles that have already started. Players of all teams can see what perk each content creator has activated at any time. You will also be able to join in the Team Clash Fun after the event has started, as the event will come down to the very last battles. If you join a team that falls behind, you'll get a special bonus. It'll become active on the second day of Team Clash. With it, you'll be able to earn more points in the 7v7 mode for 10 battles and help your team claw back and even maybe retake the lead. But remember, you won't be able to join a team from February 6th, 1 o'clock UTC onwards.
Pretty much what they are saying right there, boys and girls, is very, very, very simple. They are saying when you are picking the team, you need to perform in the battle if you want to boost the things up, let's say like that. Clicking on one or another team is not giving anything, and you are being part of the team, but not, you are not participating in the team. What they are trying to do right there is very, very simple. What they are doing right here is they are pretty much, if you want to be a big part of the team, you pretty much need to play random battles a bit to get those bonuses, and then you need to play 7v7 if you want to boost the things up and you are getting yourself some rewards and so on, so on, which is very, very good thing. Now the other thing is content creators will have some boosters, so they are going to be as a captains, as a generals of their army, or however to say that, and they will be able to use certain boosters and so on, so on.
In Team Clash, you'll earn not only personal and team points, but other rewards. When you accumulate 60 personal points, you reach a new level, as well as receive a pleasant bonus, the content creator reward for merit. This is different from a regular reward for merit and contains more substantial prizes. Your level is closely tied to your team's progression.
You are getting more free stuff for yourself while playing.
And you will get a reward for reaching each stage if your personal level is high enough. A medal, emblems, inscriptions, decals, and a special style await you. There are additional rental vehicles for the 7v7 battles at certain stages too. When you reach level 10 of personal progression, you'll be able to get all the team rewards. But if you're ready to continue fighting for your commander, you will receive the content creator reward for merit up to level 30. The final reward you will get once Team Clash is over is the unique commander. It will look and sound just like the famous content creator captaining your team. And he'll come with Sixth Sense as a zero.
This
perk.
Is pretty the much the main prize, Commander and the sound of Commander. Unlocked.
The team that comes second will have two, and the team ranked third will have only one. While the commander of the team that comes last will just have the Sixth Sense perk. Do you want to get even more styles and decals, including other teams' ones? There is a way. You can purchase the styles and decals of...
Now this is extremely important thing, my lovely friends. There is another way how you can get other content creator stuff, their camos, their stuff, and so on, so on. But you need to open the wallet. And now the most important question. But scale! No, I am not getting a single penny out of it. You can buy 17 commanders, no one, I am not going to get any use whatsoever, and this is the most important thing, and I want and I will be 100% transparent with you. So everything goes to Wargaming, which is completely fine. Now you might ask, but skill? No, I am feeling extremely happy for not getting anything out of all this. The main and the most important thing, after those kind of events, no one is going to say, skill, you are sitting in Wargaming pocket. No. Fellas, this is not how the things is working like, and I have my freedom, I can speech, I can say what do I think about the things, and I think I am known for honesty. If something is good, I'm saying congratulations, this is a good stuff. If something is bad, I am saying, guys, you need to do something about it. Minds encounter. And so on, you know? And I want to be 100% honest with you, and I think this is information which every single of you should know. Let's continue.
All Team Clash teams as many times as you want. Fight, win, and earn points for your team's triumph. Prove that your favorite content creator is the best, and that there's a whole army of committed tankers behind them. Good luck in Team Clash.
Pretty much what is happening right here, there is four different teams, people is going to pick their teams, people is going to pick their favorite content creators and everything, and the team which is going to get the most support, team which is going to have the most active players is going to win this event, and if your team which you are selecting is winning, you are getting yourself commander, which can have up to the four skills, if I understood that correctly, commander skill and three extra skills. If your team finishing second one, you are getting two skills and three sixth sense. If your team is third, a sixth sense and three skill. And if your team is fourth, hashtag never lucky, you are getting the commander with a free sixth sense, which is not bad whatsoever. It's like a girl in the game when you are completing missions, which is good stuff, right? Now the other thing, what is the most important, the commanders have their soundtracks, right? So every single guy, all World of Tanks phrases like we hit them, that hurts and everything, they are going to have those ones and they are going to have their unique ones.
Banana out of 10. Let's get the show on the road. Let's piri piri.
And so on, right?
Guns damaged. We're throwing potatoes at this point. Guns damaged. We're throwing potatoes at this point.
And these games... So here you go. This is the most important thing, right? I don't know how people love their camos and stuff, but probably this is the most important thing to hear your favorite content creator in the battlefield or to have as commander. This is probably the biggest award. If you are wondering what kind of camo we have, I had a chance to pick some kind of camo, right? And I went with this one. Why? Because this one had the most of the yellowish color for bananas, fellas. For bloody bananas. So once again, if you are interested into all this, links are going to be under description. Read everything yourself. If you fight for your, let's say like that, fight for your favorite content creator, you are enjoying the Myland, join his team, you are enjoying awesome epic guys, go for those guys, you love Death Games content, go for with the Death Games, he's extremely good guy, and I love him with all my heart, or pick me, it is completely up to you what you are going to do, and this is extremely bloodyful opportunity. What do I mean by saying that, fellas? How often content creator can get inside of the game? And this is not about the money, because once again, I am not getting a single penny out of it, and I don't want to. This event is for you. You have a chance to pick your favorite content creator, and whenever you are having a shitty ass day or something, you are putting that into your favorite tank. It doesn't matter what you are, what you love to play, and you can hear, you know, a good words from your favorite content creator. Also, if you are going to pick me and you are going to put me into the art, you are going to burn in the hell, just saying. Thank you so much for watching, boys and girls. I hope you enjoyed this one. That was quite unique. I did this commentary for a very first time in my life, and I hope it was something different. Good luck, fight for your favorite team, and see you on the battlefield, fellas. Peace.